2017, October 20th. We'll have the tomato steak there, basil, and right before that stone basil. So we'll have four because they grow out if they do anything like they did this year. Well, I have that cement, the piece of a cylinder right there, cinder tomato, right where that knife is right there, tomato. And then in between these two, again, they're not going to be exactly in a row even, so it might be where that one is. So that's three tomatoes. So we'll do three rows, or we might do a fourth row. And then maybe I could put an X. See if it's right where that cinder is, right there. Debating whether I want to put a basil back here or not. I don't know yet. But tomato. Maybe right here, tomato. Yeah, about here, tomato. And then see with these plants in here still, these are the ending of it. They got pods on them still growing. They got new growth on them. I'm letting them go until it gets down below 34 degrees. And I'll just let it stay out here little by little and get some more. But yeah, so I want, like I say, tomato, but when I say there's where that steak knife is there. And so maybe right there, maybe right here, maybe two, and maybe put one right there, three, because that steak, there's going to be a tomato plant there, and they get full, so I might even make another hole right here, three, and four somewhere up here. So that's all going to be done when it's time, because it's just too hard to do it. Like I say, I got all these cuts in here from other things that we've grown, but we're going to have three rows at least, maybe have four rows, but three rows of tomatoes. I was wanting to do four deep from north to south, so we'll have to play it by ear, but it could be three or four, by three or four from east to west. And then, and peppers, that's the other thing, I got peppers. I'm going to plant two rows of different types of pepper, bell peppers and jalapeno peppers, and then maybe some ghost or fish, fish peppers. We have a whole abundance of those this year, a lot. I want to give some of our neighbors way over there in that trailer. I took them some things, not a lot, but a few things. And I got some peppers to take over there, some tomatoes. And see, a lot of this, there's holes down here, you can't really see it. But only something growing up here. So we'll have like three to four rows of tomatoes and then two rows of peppers. And where that cinder block is back there, that small short one there, that's where we're going to fold the plastic up to there and till it up. We're going to leave this little piece here. We're not going to do anything with it. And then here's the edge. Let me see. Number one garden is on this side, number two right here. But see, in the middle here is where we're going to have garlic. We're going to put two or three rows. There should be about 15 garlic bulbs. Cloves going down here, so we'll have about 45 garlics coming out next year. Plant those in another week or two. But this will be nothing for about where that cinder block is back there, I was saying, to around where that cinder block is. That one there. So that one there. Nothing. It'll be plastic like this. Then we'll do the same thing. We'll try to tear this up and fold it back, till it up. Thinking about putting okra up here in number one garden, which is what we did last year. It was so many okra we had. Year before last, actually, there was so much of it. We just planted about 12 to 16 okra, and that's more than enough. So then we have room over here for cucumbers. We have about, you can see like holes, pre-existing holes. We use them and cut more. Maybe one where that is right there. Right there, so you have, and I put two seeds in each one, so, and it'll probably grow 2, 4, 6, 8 maybe cucumbers, and then watermelon and cantaloupe over here. Okay, because this gets the sun the earliest in the morning and the longest, you know, because it comes down, it rises up over there in the east, in the shadow in the summertime. Even though, like I say, the shadow right now is south. My shadow is going north, west instead of more west. Or even that way, it's way over here. It's noticeably different. But it's okay. I mean, no one says anything about the poisons in the sky. So, you know, put your head back down. Walk right off a cliff. But, yeah. So it'll be watermelon and cantaloupe over here and cucumbers in the middle with the plastics. It's going to be just plastic. In the sun, yeah. And then my sunflowers are going to go around again. That's the only one that's going to stay where it's at. That's about 20 feet off of the garden on the west end here. And then about, I'd say, close to where that burn barrel is there. Going across. I would actually do the back over there. I might do the back but where it was at before. Even with that last plant, and just go all the way across, it keeps their crap away as much as possible. But the one on the east side, I want to bring it closer. There you go. Seriously. I get just to the top. There you go. See that? It's an elephant ear. It's an umbrella for out here. Or shade. That's what they used to do. Is, you know, the Egyptians used to sit there and pan them with that. Anyway. Alright. So, it would be watermelon, cantaloupe, cucumbers, peppers and tomatoes, beans and peas over in here. And actually right here would be three rows, about 14 or 16 garlic all the way back. I have to measure it out. And just didn't chill it up. I'm not going to do anything. And then we'll put plastic back down over in number two again. So it'll be like a big 5-foot swath in the middle again. And it's going to be hard. See, that's the thing with all the grass out here. We're not using no chemicals. So the grass keeps growing up through it all the way. Unless you have plastic. Even with the plastic, it grows through a lot. But we haven't been able to do it. Our health is going down. So we can't get down and pull out the grass like we had the year before last. And last year was so-so. But that's what I say. It's getting to the point where people can't do anything like this. Stock it up and have it last you for about 2 years. And then by that time, you know, you don't have the health to go out here and garden and have anything worth anything. So after this year, probably won't be tilling this plastic, taking the plastic up and tilling underneath again. I don't know if we'll be able to just use the plastic as it is and put down like we were doing the first year where we had a handful of 15 fertilizer and then putting a little bit of Epsom salt in with the tomatoes and the peppers in the ground and then put the plant down in there, a little dirt in the plant, if that's what we'll have to try doing. But okra, you can put one little pebble, one little seed, looks like about the size of a BB, a little bit smaller than a BB actually, and they come up like trees. So that's what this will look like next year. So I'll be okra, we'll probably do about 5 across and 1, 2, 3. We actually should do 3 deep. Might do 4, or unless we do like 1, and then 2 is a little bit further over than 3, and then 4 like that. But it'll be tall tree looking, like little evergreens out here. Watermelon, cantaloupe, cucumber, plastic, peppers, and tomatoes. And then okra, that whole garden there, and then this will be beans and peas. And right in the middle here would be garlic. I'd love to be able to do our onion too. Might still try that, I don't know. But if we can get onion, I would love to grow my own onion. It's probably just the same as the garlic. But with those little black seeds about the size of a grain of sand, growing them inside where you gotta start them, and this house stays cool. So the old the center part used to be a log cabin in the 1800s, and they added onto it and put siding on it. So drafty, pretty much. The floor is ice cold in the wintertime because you see the cement, bricks on the bottom there. All right, just about 4 inches below that is dirt all the way onto the other side. So, and then we got the west wide open. North, the coldest part, wide open. East, the next coldest part, wide open. The south is pretty much the same on the other side of the house. So the little bit of break we get from the sheds is nothing. That's nothing. if we had like about 5 more trees, 6 more trees, that would make a difference. Not a lot, but it would make a difference. And all the trees right here too, they all got brown spot, all of them. And it's kind of taking its toll on this garden. So I say we're trying to do the best we can with what we got. Next year, we'll see what we can do. If we can try to do a halfway decent job this year, tilling that half, putting the plastic back, tilling this half, putting the plastic back, till this again yet. I got that's all basil, by the way, dead basil that was pulled up. I'm gonna till it into it. Till this up, this will be where okra's at. Putting the plastic back. Plant the torch sunflowers. They're still blooming. That's pretty cool. And then sunflowers around the garden. The back wall is the main one to get out from all the chemicals from the Monsanto crap. And the west wall here. This one too, but you know, you got a little bit of a break from the road, but still I'd like to have a wall right there of flowers in the back and the west end. And it won't do a whole lot, but it'll do something. I'm not going to China Mart and buying their crap that everybody else does. If you buy any ground beef or anything like that, if you eat that from China Mart, you're probably getting, they say, in the mix from 6,000 cows. You don't know, it's just all mixed. You don't know, and it's all in a little stall where they live their whole life and then they just kill them. Yeah, it's very cruel what they do. So, oh yeah, I want to plant purple basil. I might do that. I might do the center too is purple basil and put green basil on the corners. So, that's it.